Today, we're getting a behind-the-scenes look at Oak Ridge Enhanced Technology and Training Center, better known as ORTTEC. Dr. Ashley Stowe, the director, is going to take us on a deep dive at how ORTTEC is leveraging virtual reality and augmented reality to provide some of the best training for dynamic and advanced emergency management when it comes to security and operations training for high consequence and critical infrastructure operations when it comes to nuclear security, as well as dive in just the everyday operations with radioactive material.
This is the Oak Ridge Enhanced Technology and Training Center, which is a new training center as part of Y-12. At ORTTEC, we have a mission of providing unique enhanced training in high consequence scenarios. For us, we look at that in two main areas, nuclear processing and radiation response.
There's a lot we could dig into, but due to security concerns, today we're going to talk about augmented reality and virtual reality when it comes to handling nuclear material. At ORTTEC, under Dr. Stowe, there's a whole host of training that goes on for first responders all across the country, including scenarios of full-on building assaults. Say, bad guys want to break into your local hospital and steal radioactive material out of medical equipment. First responders across the nation come to ORTTEC to get that training of how to handle and what to do in such a scenario.
We're in our extended reality research lab. So extended reality is this bundle term that talks about augmented reality and virtual reality, the ability to see digital things with our real eyes and be able to interact with them to enhance how we're doing things. In our extended reality lab, we're actually doing research to come up with new ways to train glove box operators. At Y-12, we deal with a lot of uranium and uranium manufacturing or uranium processing. What we try to do is teach people how to interact with things like this. This is a glove box. The whole purpose of it is to protect the human from the material and the material inside from the environment around it. Uranium is a unique material with unique hazards, and we have to do all of our work inside of this glove box. Well, most people don't know what this is, and oftentimes when we hire folks, they've never seen one of these, don't know how to interact with it. More importantly, don't know the pain of interacting with it. It's an incredibly useful tool, but it also has some unique hazards. You're working at a distance, you have restraints, you have to contort your body and reach. Everything seems to be just a little bit too far away. It requires you to have special techniques to be able to work in that environment. And oftentimes it is a physical and mental stress. And so we want to help people understand how to work in a glove box before we introduce the hazards so that if they make mistakes, they can still go home at the end of the day. So we have this physical glove box, but the reality is these are expensive and we don't have them sitting around everywhere. And so we use what are called digital twins. We take a physical object and we make a copy in a digital environment, whether it's using CAD drawings, engineering drawings, or we have incredibly talented staff members who can 3D model them at scale so that we can visualize them inside of a virtual reality headset or an augmented reality headset. And with augmented reality, you'll be able to see a digital glove box that is about 10 feet high, 26 feet long, takes up most of the room that we're in, and yet you can also still see the room around you. You'll still be able to see the people. That allows us to duplicate these things and let people work with them without needing to have the physical equipment, especially early on in their training experience. And so we have multiple formats. Again, we have virtual reality, which allows you to see the digital, but you lose all understanding of the physical world around you. You kind of, like Ready Player One, go into this imaginary world, whatever we create for you, and you don't see anything else. While the simulation does quite a bit, it does not get us all the way to being able to feel the haptic feedback is what it's called. The perception that we're holding something, the weight of an object or the torque that you have to put on an object to be able to move it around. And so that's where we go a step further. We have something called haptic gloves. These gloves, unique in that on the underside of them, there's hundreds of little micro bubbles that can be filled with air pressure and inflate those bubbles against the human skin. As they inflate, it puts pressure on the human skin and it gives you the sensation of the surface texture or something touching your skin. Additionally, there are little wires here that will constrict or tighten as you get resistance. So if you press on the digital glass, it will give you resistance as though there's a physical pane of glass in front of you. And what that does is it tricks your mind into thinking there's something physically in front of you. And we've seen people work at a distance. They have their arms extended out from them working, which is not the best ergonomic position, but it is a realistic position if you're working inside of a glove box. So we can get a sensation of the surface texture, of feeling an object, of picking up an object, of the weight of that object with these gloves, even though you're not actually touching anything. And so for folks that have never worked in this environment, this is a great way to teach them, to give them that real experience and let them make mistakes in a way that doesn't have high impact on the equipment or on their physical health.